Hello everyone, welcome to the second session of the 2D Geometrical Transformation. Myself, Professor P.G.Chitte, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the second session, we will discuss some numericals based on 2D Geometrical Transformation. Learning outcomes. At the end of the session, the student will be able to solve the different numerical based on the different types of 2D geometrical transformation such as translation, scaling and rotation. These are the contents. First, we will see the recap of the first session. After that, we will see the numericals based on the transformations like the translation, scaling and the rotation. So what we have discussed in the first session? We have discussed like what is meant by the geometrical transformation. Geometrical transformation will help you to observe the geometrical entity very easily with the help of different geometrical transformations like translation, that is moving, rotation. We have to provide the angle to the particular geometrical entity with respect to a coordinate. After that, scaling, we have to zoom in or the zoom out for the particular area so that we can see that particular area, maybe the surface or maybe the edge, very easily. We can provide the orientation with respect to the current configuration. What is the in general equation for the geometrical transformation, that is P dash is equal to L of P, where P dash is the modified image and P will be our original image. Here, first we will see the translation. So, in the translation, equation is X dash Y dash is equal to XY plus TX TY, where TX TY is translation matrix. We have discussed like we have to suppose we have to move a particular point or maybe we have to move a particular geometrical entity from one coordinate to the another coordinate, where X dash Y dash we will be our modified coordinates, XY will be our original coordinates and TX TY will be our translation matrix. For the similarly triangle ABC, so this will be our modified triangle, that is triangle A dash B dash C dash, that is A dash X B dash X C dash XY is equal to A dash, sorry, AXY B XY and C XY plus TX TY, where TX TY is our translation matrix. Rotation. Here we are rotating the particular original point, that is P, through the angle theta, and we can get the modified point, that is P dash X dash Y dash. We know the equation, that is X is equal to R cos phi and Y is equal to R sin phi with the help of this diagram. So X dash is equal to R cos theta plus phi. So R cos theta cos phi minus R sin theta sin phi. We can put these values of X and Y here from the equation 1. So X dash is equal to X cos theta minus Y sin theta. This will be our first equation. So similarly, Y dash is equal to R sin theta plus phi. So sin theta plus phi is equal to sin theta cos phi cos theta sin phi. So R into sin theta cos phi plus R into cos theta sin phi. So we can put the values of X and Y here. So Y dash is equal to X sin theta plus Y cos theta. That will be our second equation. So whenever we are combining the equation 1 and 2 regarding the X dash and Y dash, so we can get X dash Y dash is equal to X Y modified coordinates, original coordinates into the rotational matrix, that is cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta. This is the rotational matrix. The in general equation is the P dash is equal to P into R, the modified coordinate equals to original coordinate into rotational matrix. Scaling. So here we are zoom in or the zoom out the particular geometrical entity. Here we are taking the triangle, example for the triangle. So ABC is our original image and A dash, B dash, C dash is our modified image by the scaling factor XX and SY. So X dash is equal to X into SX and Y dash is equal to Y into Y SY. Similarly, A dash X, A dash Y is equal to AX, AY into SX 0, 0 SY. For the similar triangle ABC, so triangle ABC, so A dash, B dash, C dash will be our modified triangle. So A dash X, A dash Y, B dash X, B dash Y, C dash Y is equal to AX, AY, BX, BY and CX, CY. This will be our original coordinates of the triangle into SX 0 and 0 SY, where SX and SY will be our scaling factors. Let's think about this question. Write the parametric equations of the types of the geometrical transformations like the translation, scaling and the rotation. We have discussed this. Now we will move to the main part, that is the numerical based on the translation, scaling and the rotation. First we will see the problem regarding the translation. So this is the statement. How the triangle ABC will be translated with the coordinates A25, B29 and C85 by the 10 units in X direction and 20 units in Y direction. So TX is equal to 10 and TY is equal to 20. So this will be our the equation for the translation. By keeping the values in the equation, we are knowing the values of AXY and BXY and CXY. So AX is equal to 2, AY is equal to 5, BX is equal to 2, BY is equal to 9 and CX is equal to 8 and CY is equal to 5, and we are knowing the values of TX and TY, that is 10 and 20 respectively. So we can get the values of A dash XY, B dash XY and C dash XY like 12, 25, 12, 29 and 18, 25. So after the translation, the points are A dash 12, 25, B dash 12, 29 and C dash 18, 25. So this will be the diagram after the translation transformation. This will be our original triangle, and after the translation transformation, we will get the new modified triangle, that is A dash, B dash and C dash. We will move to the next numerical. Rotate a point P10, 5. This is the original point, that is P10, 5. By counter clockwise, this will be our counter clockwise, by 30 degree, that is theta, and find the rotational matrix and the resultant point. First we have to find out the rotational matrix, that is R, and the resultant point, that is P dash. Now we know the equation P dash X dash Y dash is equal to P X Y into cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta, where cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta is our rotational matrix. So here rotational matrix, so cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta, so theta is 30 here, so cos 30 sin 30 minus sin 30 cos 30, so 0.66 0.5 minus 0.66 0.5. So this will be our rotational matrix. By keeping the values of the original coordinates, so 10 and 5, that will be our PXY into the rotational matrix, so we will get the X dash and Y dash here. So X dash and Y dash are 6.16 and 9.33 respectively. So here this is our original coordinate, that is P10, 5. After the rotational by angle theta by 30 degree, this will be our rotational angle. We will get the point P dash, that is 6.16 and 9.33. Now, the third problem. Scale the rectangle A minus 1 minus 1, B 1 minus 1 and C 1 1 and D minus 1 1. These are the coordinates for the rectangle A, B, C, D, by 2 units in X direction and 2 units in Y direction, means SX is equal to 2 and SY is equal to 2. These are the our scaling factors. So this will be our original rectangle, that is ABCD, we have to find out A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. So, we are knowing the Sx and Sy. Also, we are knowing the equation for the scaling. In the last session, we have discussed that. So, A dash Xy, B dash Xy, C dash Xy, D dash Xy is equal to AXY, BXY, CXY, DXY into Sx0 and 0Sy, where this matrix will be called as the scaling matrix. We are knowing the values of scaling factors, that is Sx is equal to 2 and Sy is equal to 2. By keeping the values, so these are the values that will be our original coordinates for the AXY, BXY, CXY and DXY into Sx is equal to 2 and Sy is equal to 2. So we will get the modified coordinates for the points, that is A dash minus 2 minus 2, B dash 2 minus 2, C dash 2 2 and D dash minus 2 2. So this will be our resultant new rectangle after the scaling transformation. These are the references. Thank you.